Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and here's another video about an argument that a person who's against gay marriage will bring up, and here's my counter-response to it. In a way, I think this is like the crux argument. This is like the argument that at the end of the day, this is what opponents of gay marriage want to argue. At the end of the day, this is what it comes down to, I think. And it's not usable, fortunately, in a court of law. This argument will hopefully never happen in the Supreme Court or any other courts or any legal places. But this is the argument that, you know, a lot of people, I would even say majority of people against gay marriage will like to argue. And that's that gay marriage, or not gay marriage itself, but homosexuality as a whole is morally wrong. And if you're religious, you'll go so far as to say that it's a sin against God. It's an abomination against God. Because it's still morally wrong, there shouldn't be gay marriage. This is something that my dad as a pastor will argue. And it's probably the only argument he'll make. I don't think he ever thought about homosexuality enough to consider any of the other arguments I brought up. He is really, I haven't talked with him too much about this issue. But we did once or twice, and this is the argument that he sticks with, you know, that homosexuality is a sin. It's morally wrong. And of course, because it's morally wrong, the government should not condone it, should not recognize it by even allowing gays to be married. That's the argument. It comes down to this, and this is I don't know if you can have a logical debate, you know, if that's the argument here. Because it's hard for me to counter that. Like, what do you expect me to say? Other than, I totally disagree. Because that's my argument here, is just, I don't think it's morally wrong at all. You know, I don't think it does any moral harm. I think homosexuality is totally okay. I think it's natural for gay people, and for lesbians, and for bisexual, and for transgender and transsexual. I think it's totally okay, totally natural. And I, from everything that I've seen and experienced and read, I think people are born that way. I don't think it's a choice at all. There is no morality to be held, no morality debate to be held here. That's my stance. But that doesn't really, I don't know, we can't have a debate. And that's why I made that video one time. Like my very first YouTube video on this topic, on gay marriage, was that the majority of the opponents of gay marriage are so emotionally and especially religiously invested in this debate that whatever arguments that they come up, any other argument other than this argument that we're having right now, are just excuses, or anything that they could come up with to say, hey, gay marriage shouldn't be illegal. You know, they're whatever they could come up with, because they have this religious argument that they can't say, that's not usable. In a court of law, in the Supreme Court, they can't use this argument that they want to use, so they just come up with these other arguments about procreation, about what about polygamy, about what about religious liberty, you know, and all these other things. So I think this is what it comes down to, and honestly, my response is pretty much just that. I highly disagree. Now, When I think the opposition, though, will try to come up with something to make their argument stronger. Sometimes I see them bringing up pedophilia. So they'll ask this question like, well, what do you think? What do you think about pedophilia? Do you think it's morally wrong? You know, couldn't that be argued as a sexual orientation that you're born with? Aren't pedophiles born that way? Well, then how is it morally not wrong? So that I will address that. Because I think I can definitely respond to that. Because, yeah, I view pedophilia as wrong. So, but let's go into that. Why is it different than homosexuality? So, the difference, I think... Okay, first disclaimer. I personally don't know enough about pedophilia. I don't think I've read enough on it. And I definitely haven't, you know... I don't know any pedophiles. Maybe... I don't know. I don't know any pedophiles. So I'm not an expert on how pedophilia is developed or is inherent. You know, I don't know if pedophilia is something that people are conditioned into or people learn, or if it is something that you're born with. I don't know. I can't say either way. If it is a sexual orientation that someone is born with, I think that's really unfortunate, because for the good of society, I don't think that can be acceptable. And I think it should be considered totally illegal as it is, even if it's considered a sexual orientation. And here's why. The reason is because, okay, there is this pedophile who's born with this sexual orientation. What about the person he's sexually attracted to, which is pretty much a kid? You know, I don't know how old the kid is, but it's a kid. 13-year-old, 12-year-old, 11-year-old, all the way down to, like, a baby. It's a kid. Are kids born with this orientation of seniorphilia or elderphilia? Are there kids out there who are like, oh no, I'm only attracted to really old guys or 40-year-old adults, even though I'm 5 years old. Is that a sexual orientation? Okay, so that's an unanswerable question right there. I hope we don't answer that question, because that's a really weird thing to answer. But that's an unanswerable question right there. Adding to that is the fact that, can you ever argue that these kids are consenting to sexual relations? I don't think it can ever be argued that the kids are consenting. And since that's the case, pedophilia, or an act of pedophile, it can be considered as, you know, child molestation, child abuse. It can even be considered a form of rape. And rape is definitely morally wrong. So, in case of pedophilia, even if you're born with it, I think it's morally wrong. And if it comes down to this choice, this binary choice of violating a pedophilia's rights to have sex with a kid, versus the choice of accepting pedophilia and all the harms that would do to society, I would choose, of course, obviously, to violate the rights of pedophilia, because, you know, that shouldn't be accepted or allowed. So yeah, I think in a case like pedophilia, that's morally wrong, even if it is a sexual orientation. I don't know enough to say whether it's sexual orientation, but if it is, yes, that would be morally wrong. Homosexuality is definitely a sexual orientation. And is it morally wrong? I don't think it is. Who does it harm? In the case, it's not rape, it's two consenting adults. Let's not bring polygamy into this discussion. But if it can be argued that, let's not, because that's actually, I'm going to make a video on polygamy, just on polygamy, so I'll get to that in another video. But in this video, two consenting adults, straight or homosexual or transgender, transsexual, two consenting adults, what's the harm? What's the moral harm? Why is it morally wrong? And so I just differentiated between pedophilia, and, you know, I guess, do I need to differentiate between bestiality too? Because really, do I need to do that? I don't think I need to do that. One thing I'll say is I don't think it's morally wrong. Okay. So, oh yeah, I remember. I also would like to ask, where does it come from? Where does your morality saying that, you know, homosexuality is wrong, where does it come from? If you're arguing my Bible or my holy book or Quran or whatever says it's wrong, well, the thing is, in America, we have this thing called separation of church and state. Whatever is, you know, a biblical law or a Quranic law or a hadith or a Jewish law in a text, doesn't mean that it should be law of the land in the United States. It really doesn't work that way. Plus, if you're using the Bible, on something like marriage, it's kind of hard to argue that gay marriage should be illegal, because the Bible condones a lot of different kinds of marriages. One that I'm horrified by. You know, there is this commandment in Deuteronomy that says, if a rapist rapes a woman, I guess that's what a person who, if there's a person who raped a woman, that rapist must marry the victim. Which is, what the fuck? You know what I mean? Like, what kind of law is that? But then here's the context that, you know, people, you know, Christian believers are like, no, that's not what it's saying. It's saying that the father has the permission. So if, because in that society, in that time, in biblical times, in an Israeli or Jewish society, you know, it was much worse for a woman to, you know, be living without her virginity and shunned in her society than to actually be a married spouse of her former rapist. So it's actually better for her socially. Okay, I get that. I get that it was better for that for that time in that place. So pretty much is saying that Bible is not timeless. Okay, I get that. It also is a weird law because under the father's permission is the context. So if a person rapes a woman, that person must marry the victim if the father permits it. Which father would? What kind of father would permit? I don't know. So most likely, father would not permit. If the father doesn't permit, Bible also says, okay, that's fine, but the rapist must pay the father about 50 like currency units of something, 50 shekels or something, gold or whatever, must pay the father, and that's pretty much it. Which makes me conclude, okay, so according to biblical law, if I was freaking rich, I can rape whoever I want to, how many times I want to, because hey, oh, I raped your daughter, but I have this money that I'm going to pay to you, so off I go. Really? Okay, I'm being really crude against the Bible here, I know, I just pretty much offended a lot of Christians by saying that. But that's the biblical law. If that's the kind of law that the Bible has, why should we be concerned with the Bible when we're forming a law about marriage, you know? And Bible also condones polygamy. It also, you know, when we even, especially the Old Testament, before the Gospels, you know, condones polygamy, condones concubines, condones marriage between a slave of a wife and a man. Like, that's like slavery slash polygamy. What the hell is going on in that picture? You know what I mean? If you're using the Bible as the basis of morality for marriage, I'm really glad that's not what we're using in the court of law in the United States government. And I'm really glad there's a separation of church and state there. But as I've said in my previous video about this topic, you're free to believe whatever the hell you want, as long as that belief doesn't translate into conduct that should be considered illegal by the government.